Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Nom, 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 nom. Why not on a day like today? Cool off with a little bit of ice cream. There's Madeline Snyder and her mother Allison having a little bit of the sweet stuff at Ruster's along Columbia Avenue in East Hemphill Township in Lancaster County. Not quite that warm, but it's definitely above average for this time of the year. And we're going to stay mild all the way through the evening hours with kind of a mild breeze, mostly clear skies, 52 to 58. We'll go down into the upper 40s for nighttime lows tonight. And those are our average daytime highs for this time of the year. The clouds will thicken up just a little bit. We'll call it partly cloudy. Then we'll become overcast during the day tomorrow and windy and kind of warm with a little bit of showers arriving in the late afternoon into the evening hours. That's after a high temperature of 62 to around 68. Winds will be out of the southwest 15 to 25 miles per hour and gusty. And then they'll be switching around to out of the northwest by tomorrow night. Sunrise tomorrow at 6:29, by the way. River stages, not too much happening there. We haven't had any real soaking precipitation in a while, so they've been slowly falling. As we look outside right now, officially Harrisburg National Airport, just some thin high-level clouds and 63 degrees. The atmosphere is kind of dry. The relative humidity is only 26%. Winds are out of the southwest at around 16 miles per hour. Across the region, warm temperatures for this time of the year abound. Elizabethtown, Lancaster County is 62. Lebanon's at 62. Shamokin's at 59. 60 degrees in Lancaster, 63 in Chambersburg, and Oxford, 59 Chester County, Coatesville coming in around 57. So just a little cooler, relatively speaking, towards the east. Now our predictors showing temperatures staying in the 50s through the evening hours. The clouds moving in tonight and the southerly breezes will help keep temperatures up. So we already have a high starting point for numbers tomorrow. We should easily get into the 60s again for one reason, the high starting point in the morning. But we also have the southerly winds, and we'll have a little bit of sunshine in the morning for the clouds to get here. Here about 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, we start to see a drop-off in temperatures across the north. That's where the clouds will really be thickening up, and that's where the showers will start moving in. So there is still some cold air on the map across the country. It's still kind of bottled up in Canada like it has been for most of the season. We'll just get another piece of this behind that front as it goes through tomorrow night. Not a whole lot of precipitation, just a few showers, and then looks like kind of a quiet weekend, just relatively cooler compared to, you know, mid-60s for tomorrow. Windy, warm showers tomorrow evening, then windy and a little cooler on Friday, 52, 48 on Saturday, so a little closer to our average daytime highs. Don't forget, we turn the clocks springing ahead. You always want to say we're going back to daylight saving time. You trip yourself up on that all the time. Yeah, back to daylight saving time, but you spring the clocks forward. And then more rain
next Monday.
We know
what you mean. All right, thank you.
We're going to lose an hour's sleep is the bottom line. That's
what it means.
But we're going to gain all that sunlight. All right.